Welcome to Show and Tell with the Two Mortgage Guys. Today we'll be discussing reverse mortgages. What is a reverse mortgage? Who's it for? A real life scenario. Top 10 myths about reverse mortgages. Programs, how to get started. You don't want to miss this one.
All right, so this is going to be a good one, Steve. This is a program that not a lot of people really understand all the details on. So I think it's going to be nice to kind of walk through this stuff, educate people on this, because it's such a really cool, unique product. Not very many people are offering it, at least on a local level.
Right.
So we got a lot to cover today.
Yeah, a lot to cover, a lot of good information. Like you said, Ryan and I have been doing this for over 20 years, and we've known about reverse mortgages for that long because it's been around for years and years. So we used to know enough to be dangerous about it. And then we went through a 9-week certification on reverse mortgages and have just unlocked a bunch of knowledge to be able to share with everybody about it.
Yeah, I think there's a lot to share for sure. So let's kind of dive into this a little bit. So basically what we're going to cover today is, you know, what is a reverse mortgage? Who's it for? We're going to give you a real life scenario, something that, you know, makes sense, it'd be easy to understand. We're going to talk about the top 10 reverse mortgage myths, and there's probably more than that, because honestly, it's pretty misunderstood. We're going to touch base on the guidelines a little bit, and we're going to talk to you about how to get started. If it's something that you think might make sense for you, we'll tell you exactly how to move into that. So look, simply put, a reverse mortgage is a loan that is only available to seniors. It allows you to access a portion of your home equity, either in a lump sum or in monthly payments made to you. It doesn't require a monthly payment be made to your lender. Although it does accrue daily interest and can be paid off at any time, payoff's not required until the event of your death. I mean,
right.
Pretty unique, right?
It is, and it's like it's only for seniors, and it's a FHA loan, so Federal Housing Administration, so it's government insured.
Yep. So yeah. And you may have heard of it called a HECM. I hear Steve saying that in the office all the time. HECM. nobody probably on the streets call it that, but technically, yeah, it's an FHA insured loan. Now there are other types of reverse mortgage products. And I think in recent years, there's some privatized non-FHA versions that maybe allow you to borrow more money, you know, different guidelines, et cetera. But we're going to focus today on the most common one, the safest one we believe, and that's the FHA's version.
Yeah. Which is just home equity. So that, I think that's why they changed the name several years ago from reverse to HECM, because all you're doing is accessing your equity that you have currently in your house. Just like if you did a home equity line of credit, the only difference is you don't have a monthly payment when you do it with a reverse.
So right up front, who is this for, right? Who's going to benefit from a reverse mortgage? So let's just kind of walk through these together, Steve. So first one here, someone looking for additional monthly income. Think about that. Get a loan to actually get more income.
Right. More on a monthly basis. And that's what a lot of people, especially when you get in your senior years, you get on a fixed income. And we hear it a lot in here where it's like, hey, our income is not rising, but everything else is, especially right now with what we're seeing. So this is one of those ways where you can actually tap into that equity that you've got and supplement your monthly income.
Someone in need of home improvements, but doesn't want another payment, right? Or doesn't want to exhaust their savings account to do that. They've got equity in their home. That's an option to get in there and do some of these home improvements.
Right.
Someone wanting to stay at home in lieu of going into some type of assisted living. So at some point in your life, you know, maybe staying in your property, the perception or maybe the reality is there's an expense to that you can't bear. This could be a solution for staying there.
Right.
You go ahead and read some of these too.
Hey, I'll do that. But I was going to share on that. So there's actually a booklet. This is actually from HUD, Housing and Urban Development, Federal Housing Administration. You know, use your home to stay at home. And that's part of that, like Ryan was talking about. More and more nowadays, you're seeing home health care. people that want to stay in their house. They don't want to go to assisted living or go to nursing homes. They just want somebody to come in and help them out, but there's that expense. And then you've got the children in there sometimes that are stuck in between that, trying to help mom and dad and keep them at home as long as they can and take care of them. And sometimes that's a financial burden or hardship. And this is one of those options you can look at where they can tap into some of that equity and use it to stay in the house as they're doing it with it. So they can do that, also helping to pay off healthcare expenses at the same time.
Yeah, and you can imagine some of those expenses are pretty high. And there's not a realistic way to pay those off without really exhausting your savings. But yeah, there's people sitting up with tons of home equity. They could get their hands on it through this program.
Right. And they're just sitting in their house.
Yep. Someone struggling to pay all their bills after retirement. So, you know, it's one thing when you're in the workforce, if it's you or you and a spouse and you've got monthly income coming in. But what happens when you retire and you suddenly are on a reduced monthly income and you still have a mortgage, right? Maybe you wanted to pay it off, but you just couldn't. Or maybe you want to retire, but you can't because you got that mortgage payment. This could be an option,
right,
to help offset that.
It works with that. And then also the next one there, someone adjusting their household income and looking to eliminate their monthly mortgage payment, just feeding right off of that. You can retire if you're at that point, if you've got the equity in it, and you can just actually use the reverse to pay off your current mortgage without a monthly payment.
Pretty cool. And I bet a lot of people didn't know they could do that. You know, look, many, many more scenarios that homeowners may experience in their lifetime. I mean, there's a ton of different reasons why this may be right for you. So a real life scenario, I'm going to talk about a family member, and I'm not going to name any names, but let's just say I've got a family member that would love to get out of here in Indiana, get out of here in the winter, go down to Florida, January, February, March, right? I mean, how nice would it be to skip kind of the coldest weather we have? But there's an expense to that, whether you buy a home in Florida, if you're leasing, whatever it may look like. And, you know, therefore, they're not doing it. They haven't been doing it. But here's the thing. They've got a home. They're retired. They've spent their whole life making payments to pay this mortgage off in retirement years. And now that home is worth a pretty good amount of money, and they're sitting on all this equity. And what's likely going to happen is they're going to pass at some point, hopefully many, many years from now. But when they do, that home will go down to their heirs. It'll likely be sold, and the value of that home will be split with whomever they're leaving it to. But what they could do, they could take out a reverse mortgage. They could get a lump sum amount of money. It does not come with a monthly payment. They can take that money. They can invest it. They can put it in the bank account. They could use that to either buy a property in Florida, or they could use that to maybe, you know, lease a property in Florida every year. And, you know, I did the math, and we come up with, look, you could literally for the next 10 years have enough money pulled out to cover the cost of leasing a property down there for 3 months out of the year for 10 years.
And it didn't cost them anything. Won't cost them anything.
Doesn't cost them a single extra monthly debt. All they're doing is pulling out some of that equity. Now, we'll talk about this a little bit later too, but you know, now in the event of their death and the home goes down to their heirs, guess what? There's just a balance that needs to be paid, just like if someone died and had a traditional mortgage.
Right, so they had a balance on it. It did the same thing. It's going to pay off that balance, and whatever's left over is the equity that goes to the estate.
Yep, and so they have the means to do it, but they don't know they have the means to do it. They didn't know that there was a way to access that equity without selling their home or without doing a traditional cash out refinance or equity line of credit that would require a monthly payment be made.
Right, exactly. Hey, I read something earlier on, I'm going to share because it feeds right on that, but like, do you pay taxes on the money that you get back on a reverse mortgage? And the answer is no. Reverse mortgage payments, whether you take it monthly or lump sum or the home equity, is not taxable because it's considered loan proceeds and not income. So that same scenario Ryan's talking about, let's just say that amount of money is $100,000. They receive the total $100,000. They don't have to pay taxes on any of that.
Yeah, that's a great point, because there's a lot of scenarios where you would pay taxes on something like that, right?
Right.
All right, so borrower requirements. If you're still watching this, you might be thinking, man, who can do this, or I want to do it? Well, look, you've got to be 62 years or older. This is designed for seniors. 62 or older. You've got to own the home in which you'll take out the reverse mortgage on, and it has to be your primary residence. Can't be an investment property or a business or anything else. You've got to have 60% home equity or more. So look, if you've got a $200,000 house and you owe $185,000, this is probably not going to be the product for you. But if you got a $200,000 house and you don't owe anything, or you owe 50 grand, this very well could be something that allows you to get your hands on some additional equity. As far as qualifying, you know, we have to be able to show that you're capable of making your property tax installments and your homeowner's insurance installments. And, you know, because there's no payment with this, unlike a traditional mortgage, we're not trying to qualify you on your ability to make this new payment. We just need to know that you can at least pay taxes and insurance. And it doesn't necessarily, there's an option, I think, Steve, there's an option where we can pull money ahead of time and put it aside to pay those on your behalf. But
right,
gotta be able to show that you can handle that.
Yeah,
and so can't be delinquent.
Yeah.
Can't be delinquent or default on a federal debt.
Hey, one thing on that slide right before that I was going to hit on, because you hit something else on that with must own and occupy your home as your primary residence. So when you read that, that's the house that you live in the majority of the year. So another example Ryan had on the reverse mortgage, if that's your primary residence and you live there 9 months out of the year and you have a place in Florida, you can buy a second home down there and live down there in the winter months with the money that you take out of your house on the reverse mortgage and just take that to buy a property down there, as long as your primary residence is the majority of the time on it.
Yep, good point. I'm gonna let you walk through these property
requirements. Okay, so on the requirements then with the property, single family homes, 2 to 4 unit homes, one has to be occupied by those borrowers on those loans. So again, with that, it's going to be 62 or older. If there's two people, then at least one of those people have to be occupying that property, again, as their primary residence they have. If it is some type of a condominium, it's got to be HUD-approved housing and urban development. Individual condominium units that meet FHA single unit approved requirements. And so there's guidelines about all that stuff that we know how to get, where to get, and going through the appraisers and all that stuff with it. And then manufactured homes that meet the FHA requirements. So there are people out there that have that same thing that are in a manufactured home, great homes. We do a lot of those loans too, especially up in this area. There's a lot of stuff with acreage and property with it. So,
yep, for sure. So look, this is going to probably, help a lot of people feel a little more comfortable about this so far, right? Let's kind of go through these myths, and we'll go through every other one. We'll rotate with them, Steve. So I'll start us out.
Okay.
The lender or government will take my home. I mean, I got to think this is probably the biggest misconception, is that when you do a reverse mortgage, somehow you lose rights to your house, and that's not the case. This is a mortgage just like any other mortgage. The house is still yours. The mortgage company has rights to that home if that mortgage is not paid at some point. And in this scenario, it's not owed until the event of your death. And there's even other scenarios where it doesn't even have to necessarily be the event of your death.
You can sell the house, you know?
Yeah, they can sell the house to pay it. But if someone else is living in the home with you, let's say I took out a reverse mortgage in my name and I pass away, my wife is still living there. She's not going to get kicked out. She's not going to have to pay the mortgage off. She could technically stay there as long as she still qualifies and is capable of paying those insurance and taxes, right? Just like the originally,
right.
it could stay.
Yep, so that's good. And that is, we did a lot of research on that stuff too with the myths, and that's the number one myth is right there, is that, you know, the borrower is no longer going to own their home. That's the scariest thing, and that's the furthest away from it on there. So. Yep. I have to make another mortgage payment. No, on reverse mortgages, does not require monthly mortgage payments, as long as you continue to pay property taxes, homeowners insurance, and if there's any type of HOA fees, those have to be paid. We'll get more on that in myth number 8 coming up that fills in a little bit of that, like Ryan was talking about, of helping pay for the taxes and insurance.
Number 3, my heirs will be responsible for repaying the loan. Not at all. So this is what's called a non-recourse loan. So basically, you're only able to get your hands on a certain portion of your equity. So there is still, the home is still worth more than the debt. And if something, and so what happens is, let's say that I have a reverse mortgage and I pass and my kids inherit my home. and there's a balance due. Yeah, they're likely going to sell the house, pay off the mortgage balance, and any equity left over goes to them. But let's say that I took out a reverse mortgage, but something happens and the home values go down and I owe more than that house is worth. It's non-recourse. The home would be sold, mortgage would be paid, or at least as much as the value of the home, and that's it. And if there's additional money owed, that's it is what it is.
And FHA loses, right? Yeah, they're not coming back on the family, the people, or anything.
Exactly.
Yeah. So yeah. And then I'll have nothing to leave my kids. That's like another one of the top ones on there. Nothing to leave their kids with what they've got on it. So that's not true, because as home values typically increase, like Ryan said, there's always that equity that's sitting in the house, but home values are increasing. So your equity's gaining, although that interest is accruing on there with what it is. So there's going to be money retained in that property of the equity once it's sold. And that amount of money is the equity that goes back to the heirs of the estate.
Yep. So I won't be able to leave the home to my kids. Let's say your biggest concern is you just want your kids to have your home. They can still have the home. They'll have to pay off the reverse mortgage balance, but they'll still have the ability to obtain financing, or if they have enough cash, or, you know, they could still purchase that home. Nothing says that that home goes to the bank or the lender and the kids don't have an option. They sure do have an option to purchase it.
Right. And then I can't qualify because I already have a mortgage. Again, like Ryan addressed earlier, it's all just going to depend on that equity position, right? That's what they're really looking at on it. So if you've got a $200,000 house value and you've got $50,000 mortgage on it and you're wanting to retire and your payment's $1,300 a month for the next, whatever, 8-10 years, you can just do a reverse, pay that off and not have any payment. Retire, and then you're still going to get some cash back with the difference up to about that 40% mark.
Yep. Number 7, I won't be able to sell my home. Once again, it's a mortgage. If you've got a home now and you've got a mortgage on it, yeah, you can sell your home. You'll need to pay your mortgage off, right? So as long, and in fact, this is probably less risky than a traditional mortgage, because on traditional financing, there's people who borrow 100% or 95% of the value of their home. And then maybe the home prices dip and they actually owe more than the house. And it would be in that case hard to sell their home, because they would owe more than they could earn on the sale, right? But in a reverse mortgage, there's enough equity left over. You can sell your home anytime you want, pay off the reverse mortgage, and do what you want with the equity.
With the additional equity, right? Lots of people get foreclosed on these type of loans. Again, that's false with what it is. So going back to myth number 2, talking about the only thing you've got to make sure you're current on is property taxes, homeowners insurance, and HOA. So like Ryan said, part of this with the Federal Housing Administration is the ability to make those payments. If the underwriters are going through that, thinks that there might not be the ability, they're going to go ahead and estimate the taxes, the insurance, and the HOA, and they're going to collect that amount of money and hold it back, and they can make those payments on it. So it's not on everyone, but on rare circumstances, they want to make sure that they can protect the senior and keep them in the house without any problem of default on the loan of any kind.
My spouse, number 9, my spouse will get kicked out of the home if I die. So I kind of touched base on this earlier, but the reality is that's not the case. If somebody's still living in the home and the person who had the first mortgage in their name passes, as long as the person in the property is still in a position capable, can show proof that they're capable of making the tax and insurance obligations, that mortgage does not need to be paid off.
Correct. And number 10, I need more cash flow, but I'm not desperate. So this is like one of the greatest ones. This is one of the most financial, flexible tools that you've got at your arsenal. The amount of people and baby boomers that pay, like reach that goal to say, I want to have my mortgage paid off, and they paid off and they've got all this money sitting in there and they can't tap it with what they've got on it. So you can take, again, like Ryan said, lump sum monthly payment. They can set it up on a home equity line of credit. You can just pull off it as you need it, but it is an asset and it's a financial tool that you need to be able to get your hands on, and it comes with no cost to you. That's the beauty of this one.
All right, so look, hopefully we've covered enough about this to at least pique your interest, right? If you're an eligible borrower, and you're thinking, man, some of those scenarios hit close to home. Maybe this could work for me. Let us help you figure it out. I kind of mentioned it at the beginning of the video. This isn't a product that, most local banks are going to have access to or offer. We can certainly help. We're not a celebrity endorsed company.
Right.
We're not going to be dealing with somebody in a cubicle that you never meet. If you want to come meet with us face to face, you can do that. But the quickest way to start is to just give us a call. We've got the phone number here, 765-450-8933. You're going to be able to talk to either Steve or myself on that first step.
Right. And then it's super easy. I mean, we've got a basic questionnaire that Ryan and I are just going to go through. No credits pulled. Don't pull any credit on these. We do what's called a proposal. So it's basically just asking some questions, your age, date of birth, how much you owe on your house, if you have a mortgage on it, current values. This is information that Ryan and I put into a program called Reverse Vision so we can work up a proposal, and it calculates out your equity percentage that you have with it and shows you your options on if you want to take monthly, if you want to take lump sum. You can take lump sum and put some of it in a home equity line of credit, whatever you want to do, but we can get that readily available to you same day.
So we mail that out to you, you review it. You like what you see, the next step is you're required to speak with a HUD counselor. That counselor is going to ask you some questions, make sure you understand how this program works. A lot of the stuff we kind of shared in the beginning of this video. Once you get through that process, we move into whatever documentation we would need to collect and kind of moving you through the loan process, you know, whether that's having an appraisal done on the property, collecting, you know, potential documentation from you that we would need for FHA requirements.
Right. Get through the process. One thing on that HUD counselor that I always thought was great with this is that it's not an option where you can say, like, I don't want to do it. You have to talk to the HUD counselor, and the HUD counselor gets your proposal as well. So they know exactly what you're looking at, so they can go through it. So they know that it's what's benefiting you in what way. So they can go through and say, hey, here's your certificate. You went through it. Are ready to move forward with this. And then that's when, like Ryan said, we start the paperwork and take you through the loan closing on it.
All right. So once again, 765-450-8933. Give us a call. Let's chat. You know, we might be able to answer some questions right up front and figure out that it doesn't work, doesn't make sense. Nothing else. We're going to be able to get a quote to you so you can kind of see what it would look like. And we'll go from there.
Yeah.
Hope this was helpful. Love doing these show and tell episodes. Yeah. And this was obviously a no-brainer topic that we needed to cover.
And there's all kinds of information on it, but like Ryan said, call us, talk to us. If it's a parent, grandparent, or something like that, just call us. Let us give you some information on it. If it's beneficial, we'll let you know the right way.
Absolutely. All right. So next week, we've got a big show. We're going to be interviewing Billy Cardwell with Aurora Financial Strategies. He's going to talk about, you know, look, should you be paying extra on your mortgage? Or should you be investing that money? And the answer to that question is going to depend on what kind of interest rate you have. Do you have one of the newer interest rates that are in the 6-7%? Or are you still sitting at 2.5%? So be sure to tune in next week. You're not going to want to miss that one. Thanks for being here today.